event. North Florida Transportation Office. Thank you. JEA, Clean Fuel Coalition, for putting this event together. And I'm Joe Villalba, City Captain of the National Drive Electric Week. I don't know if you all know, there's 150 of these kind of events happening this week all around the country. So the whole awareness and electric cars and how economical and fun to drive is gaining ground. So I'm really excited about that. And what started, I would say last year, with a group of guys just hanging out in front of my house, having coffee and donuts, sharing stories about their electric cars, has bloomed into something bigger and better, and hopefully it just gets better. Wanda Forrest, she is a transportation planning manager and North Florida Clean Fuel Coordinator, and she has a few things to say.
Well, I just want to thank you all for coming out. It's a little bit about the Clean Fuels Coalition. We've been around since 2009, and we support not only electric, but also your gaseous fuels, propane, natural gas, LNG, and biodiesel. So this is one of our events that we have partnered with JEA and with Joel, who was our team captain. Our host agency is the North Florida Transportation Planning Organization, or a regional transportation planning agency, and and I'm staffed to that, and we hosted the North Florida Clean Fuels Coalition. So keep an ear out. We have events throughout the year, and hopefully we'll be having electric one. We'll be having an event coming up in the fall, late fall, which will host all alternative fuels, and hopefully we'll have some drive cars that you can drive too. So I am just so excited that you came out. And with that, Tom Larson, where are you?
I am a member of the board of the Clean Fuels Coalition and a leader of the Sierra Club here in the local area. Part of the Sierra Club's mission is to help deal with issues that are affecting our planet, and getting involved with electric vehicles is something that's good for your pocketbook and good for the environment. Ultimately, we hope to reduce the production of carbon dioxide so that we don't have to be worrying about what the world may become in the future. And electric vehicle ownership and use is a big part of dealing with that. So I think it's really a good thing that all of you came out, and hopefully you'll carry your experience to your friends and let them know that there's a lot of choice, a lot of options, and the pretty cool looking cars. And hopefully the future will see electric vehicles not only in those that are kind of among the enthusiast crowd, but Ma and Pa and Aunt Minnie hopefully will be driving electric cars in the future as well. So thank you very much for coming. Is there another speaker? Peter, thank you.
Thanks. So first of all, thank Joel. Where's Joel? Joel put this together. 2 years. Yeah. Thank you. Dan, we have how many EVs in Jacksonville?
On the four county area, last time I saw was
330. 330 EVs. That's plug-in and all electric. So I'll tell you, I visited Austin Energy. Just if y'all know about Austin Energy, they're a big green initiative in Austin, Texas, and we went over there to visit them, talk to them about their EV program in July, and he asked me how many EVs we had, and I think in Duval County, 180, something like that. I was surprised to hear him say that's a lot, and he said, you all are where we were about a year ago, or a year and a half ago. Austin now has 1,300 EVs in their market, so, you know, it all starts here, and I can tell you, JEA is your municipal utility. We're behind it. We believe it's an investment in the community, in the environment, in the local community. And so with that, I want to announce tonight, hopefully something to help jumpstart EVs here in Duval County, is a rebate for the purchase or lease of an electric vehicle. Okay, so it's $1,000 or $500, depending on the size of the battery. That starts tonight.
Yeah.
All right, we got applications.
Yeah.
I'm going go on the web, jea.com/electric drive as well. Fill out the application, so spread the word. And hopefully that'll drive some more EV adoption here in our community. I think we can do it. We can do what Austin did. We can be better than Austin.
Yes.
Yeah. Hey, thanks for coming out. We appreciate it. Thanks to the dealers for bringing your car for the ride and drives. Hey, get in these cars and drive. That's what they're here for.
The dealers?
Yeah, have some.
Where's the Tesla dealer?
There is none. There are none. They're all store owned.
We just invite you guys to come out and drive the i3s either here at our stores. We've got one store in Orange Park and one here in Regency. So come by and check out the i3. And the i8 will be hitting next month. We're going to have a special launch event for that. So stay tuned for more details.
All right.
Awesome. If you haven't driven one of these cars, you got to drive it. It's an experience. You just need to experience it. So anyway, thank you. Enjoy. Yeah,
thank you. I forgot to thank the local dealers for providing the ride and drive. Thank you.
Absolutely.
Thank you. And thank Whole Foods.
Absolutely. We've got a couple to choose from. We've got two here.
This is the high.
Yep. These two here. This is the top level. This is the mid trim. Mostly just cosmetic. You can tell the colors and interiors.
I'm having a grand time with my new i3 and
I wasn't there with that
versus a Tesla.